joined by Quinnipiac University, head coach Tricia Fabbri, along with Maria Napolitano, Paula Strautmane, and Aryn McClure. So, coach, would you like to make an opening statement after that great game?
Yep. You know, I've always said two toughest wins to get in any season are your first one and a semifinal one in a championship tournament. And this was certainly the case. And, you know, we certainly paid a heavy price as well with Maria's injury. So we're really pleased to be moving on into our third straight conference championship game in as many years at the MAAC. It's with a heavy heart, though, that we certainly move on without our senior leader, all-conference player, and in my estimation, the defensive player of the year, my opinion, Maria Napolitano.
Okay, great. Questions?
Coach, could you give some insight into how you adjusted emotionally and strategically after her injury?
Well, I think you saw what we've been all about for a number of years in terms of really being a team with our depth. So strategically, it was, okay, we go right to Adelaide, we keep rotating players through because we utilize our depth all the time. So strategy-wise, we were able to overcome that. Emotionally, it was difficult just because, you know, I was just hoping it was an ankle, just staying in the game, and then at halftime, I found out it was, the knee. And, that was obviously a little harder. But with that being said, we talk about always giving to your team, and when it's not you, waving the tail for your teammate. And we just said it in the locker room, Mountain said it in the locker room every time. There was an opportunity where the coaches were huddling. Maria was in the huddle, constantly giving to her team. And that's who she's been for 4 years, and even more so as a leader this year, constantly giving to the team, even when she wasn't out on the floor playing. So that helped us immensely throughout the course of the game.
Trish, what was the conversation like at halftime? You guys, the game was tied. Maria had been injured. What was that like?
It was, we've got 20 minutes to go out and find a way to win this game, because it was actually, added fuel that we're not going to do this in vain now. We're not going to have, the other way happen. We're not going to lose Maria and lose this game. It was inspiration, motivation, determination, all wrapped up into one. Fight harder.
This one's for Paula and Aryn. You guys down low had to stop Christina Mitchell, who's a 6'4" powerhouse. What was it like pre-gaming for that and then having to go through the game trying to shut her down?
Well, obviously, she's the tallest player in the team, the size of 24. But we knew that we have to box her out. We knew that we have to box guards, too, because obviously guards, they have a lot of rebounds. And we tried our best. And not only me and Aryn, the Morgan, Shuri, we all post work for that.
Yeah, exactly what Paula said. We all just had to box out. I thought we did a pretty good job of keeping her off the boards a little bit, and probably in the second half, executing more box outs than we did in the first half.
Trish, if you do win tomorrow, does the win mean so much more now that Maria is out?
Absolutely. I mean, it's just it's a tough spot for all of us, because she's been an integral part of our success, not only this season, but for her career. Again, we responded so positively to adversity today, and it's a microcosm of how we've handled adversity down 10 to Marist in the second half, down 10 or 11 to Iona. Tough losses and finding a way. Credit this team time and again in tough situations to how we respond to adversity.
This one's for Paul and Aryn. You guys combined for 7 offensive rebounds, and that really was a huge difference. I mean, a couple of them led to 3-pointers. I mean, how big was that, getting that offensive rebound, especially after that free throw?
Are you speaking to the play where she got the offensive rebound and then Brittany Johnson drilled the 3?
Oh.
Go ahead, Aryn.
I just ran in and saw the ball, and I got the ball, and passed it to Brittany Johnson, and she hit the 3. It was more of a, I don't know, just get the ball. Yeah.
It was the biggest play of the game. For Brittany to hit it, for Aryn to track it down, it obviously gave us the separation that we needed for the last minute and a half, 2 minutes of the game. It was a momentous individual effort. Time and again, Paula and Aryn have come up with those individual plays that have led to the success that we're having.
Maria, after the injury, what message are you sending to your team going forward?
Just to win this game. I told them we were capable of doing it. We were the more talented team. We just needed to dial in more on defense and, you know, just giving them a lot of confidence that we could do it, that they didn't need me to go out and win. And I knew they didn't, and they proved it, and I'm just so proud of them.
For Trish and for Maria as well, 4 straight championship games now, if you count the last year in the NEC, to come into a new conference and play for 3 consecutive championships here in the MAAC, how much does that speak to how far this program has come and continues to develop?
I mean, it's been really something special to be a part of. We're not new to championship games, and I think that's what I can provide for my team, even though I won't be taking the floor. Just knowing that it's not a different game. It's the exact same game. We've played these both teams twice in the regular season, and we've been able to beat them, and that doesn't change anything. So we just have to stick to our game plan and just take it one possession at a time.
This is what we do, and this is really why we do, this is the end game, to play for championships. This is what this program's about. We've had success, and this is where we expect to be every time come March, to be playing for a MAAC championship, to play in the NCAA tournament, to win games in the NCAA tournament.
Coach, in 2012, you had a similar situation, a semifinal game against Monmouth in the NEC that you guys were favored and ended up coming on the losing end, which has sort of fueled this run that you've been on the last few years. None of your current players played in that game, but did that game ever come up before, during, after the game?
Yeah, no, not at all, because you're dialing back to actually the young ladies who graduated last year, their freshman year. It certainly fueled the next season and the big run that we were on for the next 3 seasons with the seniors that graduated. So, not at all, actually, sorry.
I will speak to that, though, because that group who graduated last year, they made sure to remind us every single day for that next season what that loss, how they felt after that loss, and hearing that and watching that game, even though I wasn't a part of it, they made sure to, even the newcomers, to remind us that loss.
Any other questions? Right here in front.
Coach, I know it's a little awkward not knowing who you'll play tomorrow, but could you give a little snapshot of both teams and the challenges they would present to you?
Yeah, certainly. Well, both of them, we saw them both fairly recently towards the end of the season. Marist, obviously, we've seen them in the last 2 years for a championship game. Great, the player of the year, Tori Jarose. Both teams have 2 all-league players, and Lizarazu Adams, Jarose, and Sydney Coffey, featured players, veteran players. Really talented, very different styles. Maris runs the motion offense, read and react, open post. Jarose can, post up or step out. They played very well at our place the last time we saw them. We had to come from behind to win, down 10. Iona got a quick jump on us, 13-2 just last weekend, and we fought back from that deficit to win that game. It was down a few. Both teams, we were down at halftime I believe, seeing them. So they were both come from behind victories. That's probably the one similarity. It'll be different this year, game planning, because Maria had a big defensive assignment for us on Sydney Coffey and Liz Arazu. So that's going to be very a different factor going forward in the game, whoever we end up seeing.
Trish, you guys shot 10% better today than you did shooting free throws than you did the regular season. How big was that?
Absolutely immense. Outside of Brittany Johnson's shot off the offensive rebound, that was sealed the game. It did not allow it to get any closer. Sarah Olson's three, of course, kept it closer at 14 seconds. But our free throw shooting, at this time of the year, you know, it's all the little detail work, the taking care of the basketball. Again, we had 11 assists to 10 turnovers against their pressure defense. We turned them over 21 times. We did a solid job off the boards coming out of halftime and shooting the free throws as well as we did. All those little details that make big impact on the end of the games, we really executed very well.
Trish, what was the atmosphere like after the game, especially what with Maria's injury and the team now going to a final?
It was celebratory. I mean, celebratory and sad. I mean, acknowledging, you know, one of your players that is not going to be on the floor. But, you know, we have a purpose. We have a mission. We're here to accomplish it. That's what we're going to do.
Anything else? Okay. Hey, thanks very much. Congratulations.
Thank
you. See you tomorrow.
You good?
Yeah, I'm good.